Very good morning, ladies and gentlemen. This is Daniel speaking, and today I'm going to teach you five important phrasal verbs that you need to know in English. Let's start. The first one is to catch up with. To catch up with. To catch up with. To catch up with in English significa ponerse al día con algo. Ponerse al día con algo. Ejemplo, tengo que ponerme al día con mis deberes. I need, quitamos el do y ponemos, digo, un pronombre. I need to catch up with my homework. Tengo que ponerme al día con mis estudios. I need to catch up with my studies. I need to catch up with my studies. El número dos es to take back. To take back en inglés significa retirar algo que hayas dicho o devolver. Retiro mi palabra, o sea, no quise decir lo que dije. I take back my word. I take back my word. O sea, retiro lo que he dicho. I take back my word. I take back my word or my saying, mi dicho. Número tres, to speak ill of. To speak ill of. Hablar mal de alguien. Hablar mal de alguien. O sea, hablar, hacer comentarios negativos de una persona, por ejemplo. Ella habla mal de mí. She speaks ill of me. 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 Ella habla mal de John. She speaks ill of John or about John. Número cuatro. To take home. To take home or to take home. Take home es emplear, dar curro en una empresa cuando o contratar. Emplear, dar curro, contratar o tomar en serio, por ejemplo. Mi empresa está reclutando personal. My company is taking on new employees. My company is taking on new employees. O, bueno, ya sabéis que take on es reclutar, dar curro. Una preguntita. María, ¿sabes que tu empresa está reclutando personas? Mary, do you know if your company is taking taking on new employees? María, ¿sabes si tu empresa necesita empleados? María, do you know if your company is taking on new employees? Ya sabéis. Número cinco viene siendo to set up. Significa en inglés montar un negocio, montar un comercio, etc., etc. Por ejemplo, me voy a montar un negocio. I am going to set up a business. I am, ya sabes que pongo I am going, es porque la acción la voy a llevar a cabo, por ejemplo. I am going to set up a business. También set up es montar la mesa, montar un negocio, fijar algo en una pared. Por ejemplo, voy a fijar este cuaderno aquí. I am going to set this copy book or notebook here. Es como colocar en un lugar, etcétera, etcétera. Vamos a repetir de nuevo. Ya sabéis que aquí se dice to catch up with, to take back, to speak ill of, to take home, to set up something, okay? Thank you very much. Now you can practice at home with your colleague, with your friends, with your daughters, with your siblings, and so on. Thank you for your time and have a lovely day. Now I'm going to show you the place where I'm doing this wonderful recording. As you know, my name is Danny, and I'm so glad to show you this place here, all right? And don't forget, my number is, this is my number, just in case you want to get my classes. This is my number. Este número está aquí, 679-7823-71. Thank you very much. Let me show you a place that I'm where I'm now. Just give me a second, I'm preparing everything properly. That's the hotel where I'm teaching the classes now. That's the place, man. I don't know how to put the camera.
All right. Thank you very much.